Praggnanandhaa won a nice strategic game against India's Padmini Raut in round 3 of the Gibraltar Masters. He shows us what happened in the game. Prag, you won your game against Padmini today. Take us through the critical moments.
Yeah, here I think it was just equal, but she won knight d5. And now, yeah, I had to take with the bishop. And here, yeah, there is some interesting queen b3, but I don't think it just doesn't do anything. Like, even if she takes on b7, I can go rook fb8.
I have to ask you to explain to our viewers that why is it so important, because this knight d5 loses a piece, just to show us why, because of this trick. So you didn't have an option but to play bishop d5 here.
But I mean, after this also, like, our bishop is bad. And my knight, I can reroute and to c5 somewhere, like happened in the game. So
you felt you had a pleasant position already?
Yeah, I was thinking I have pleasant, but should be draw somehow. Here she found a good plan, like improve her bishop, like g3, knight d7, rook fd1, trying to get bishop f1, bishop h3.
Oh, nice. So she found the square on h3 for
Yeah, and also it controls c8, so it's not, I need to do something now.
This is actually quite a nice maneuver, no?
Yeah, I actually missed it when I played rook fc8. I saw it like after she went g3. And yeah, now first I was considering this plan, rook c1. Rook c1, rook c8. But now she's in time with rook c8, queen c8 and bishop h3.
Bishop h3 and everything gets traded off.
Yeah, and then she takes on d7 and queen b6 comes. If I go queen c5, then queen c5, knight c5, b4. And then bishop c8 comes.
And this ending is dangerous for black, but probably after the knight and bishop exchange, it should be equal.
Yeah, it should be draw. I went a5. First, I was worried of this bishop b5. But then I saw this trick, knight c5, b4. Take.
No problem, we'll just go here.
Yeah, take. Yeah, I could just...
No, it's, sometimes it happens.
Yeah. And knight b3. So queen b3, queen b6 comes.
Okay.
So
and then you just control the... But I mean, this should also be equal for... I mean, if she just takes queen b3 here, just
queen
go b6.
Queen b6. I think just already... Yeah. Already...
Black is...
Yeah, better, I think.
Black is better now.
I have active queen and sometimes I have queen e2.
Better rooks as well.
Yeah.
Okay. So here she went bishop h3.
And then... No, I need to take and play knight c5. And here, b4 was interesting. That's what I think she should have played, like a b4.
Yes.
a b4.
It's...
Yeah, and then I need to go knight a6, I was thinking. And now, rook b1. Now it's not easy for me to do something because c8 is controlled, and if I go queen c7, she can go rook c1 back.
And come back rook b1.
Yeah, rook b1. And let's say, here I was thinking to do something like g6, king g7, just try to improve. Because even if I go knight c7, she has queen b6, which
is,
I think,
annoying,
good for white.
Yeah.
And my rook is bad and probably this should be equal.
You think after b4 she could have kept the balance here?
Yeah. I mean, after bishop f1, our position got really passive. Like, I just got queen b6 and... Yeah, I think it's already a bit better for black.
So, Prag, was it important for her to control this queen b6 idea? Because then you get your pieces at the ideal.
Yeah, that's what I think. Because, like, if I put my pawn on f4, then it's already my knight on c5 is really good.
Yeah, you can never push that out.
Yeah, she should try something like b4 maybe in the...
But even now, she tried to create some counterplay on the king side.
But I think it was bad because, like, now also, like, she could have tried some king g2.
Yeah.
And actually, I was not threatening f5, because I just put my rook on f5.
You're pretending to threaten f5.
If I go f5, then my king is actually becoming weak. Let's say if I go f5, e f5, rook f5, now queen c3, let's say, and now b4 and queen c8 is a problem. If I go a4, then there might be this bishop d3, bishop e4.
And the bishop suddenly becomes quite active, yeah.
Also, some queen b4 somewhere.
You can't even trade it. Oh, maybe you can't trade it because queen c8, you have rook f8, but okay.
Yeah, it's...
It's maybe, fine for white already, no?
Some queen c3, I mean, she should try for some b4 thing, I think. She went f4. Then now it's like e4 is weak. I just go rook e8. Rook f5 and then it's... I mean, she has no counterplay actually on the king side. It looks there is something, but it's nothing, actually.
So tell me one thing, even though pieces are equal, pawns are equal, you were evaluating this position as better for you because of your active knight?
Yeah, also like, white can't do really nothing, I mean, because I put my pawn on a4.
And yeah, what is your plan? Tell us, like, what white can't do anything, but what is, how is black improving here after
a4? Yeah, just a4? Like in the game, h4, a4. H4, A4. Now I'm somewhat turning queen B3. It's like it's a bit annoying to face these kind of threats because after queen B3, queen B3, AB3, now E4 is weak and sometimes B2 is also there. Rook A4, yeah.
Yes. This is nice.
Our bishop on F1 is doing nothing. I mean, if the pawn was on F3, she could try some bishop H3. Also, that's the problem.
Yeah, but with this pawn on f5 also now bishop h3 makes no sense. And so you just want to trade off white's kind of only active queen and then get your rook and make it attack her weaknesses.
Yeah, that's why she went bishop c4. But now I have different plan. This queen a5 on just b5, b4. Yeah, g4.
But Padmini really tried to create play over here because clearly, but probably it's not on time. She's not able to do enough on time. So you went b5 here.
b5. Yeah, bishop f1. Like, you know, bishop a2, then already b4 comes.
Yeah.
Then g5, b3 is there, so. She went bishop f1, I went rook b8. I found this rook b8 because g5, queen d8. Now there is nothing on the king side. Yeah, I can't do anything.
No, sorry, just explain why this is an important move, rook b8 here.
Because I just get my rook here.
You want to play b4, b4 at some point.
Then I get my queen, like queen d8, then f6 is defended.
Right.
So, like if I go b4, still that should be better for me maybe, but I'm not sure after g5.
Some counterplay here. So, you basically want your queen to come into defense.
I just get my rook. Oh yeah, rook g2 b4. I think this already should be like practically winning for black.
Right.
Okay, bishop c4, b. Yeah, rook b1, king h2. Yeah, now I got this rook d1, rook d4 idea.
Yeah, it's very difficult.
Maybe it's not the best one, but it's not really, like, practically it's not easy for white to do it.
I mean, it's hard to defend the e4 pawn, so she has to...
Oh, yeah, bishop e2, rook d4, rook g4. And now I just thought, like, it's 38th move, I just play one more king f8 and...
So you just wanted to get through the time control.
Yeah, also, like, it improves somewhat my position because...
Yeah.
No, she went bishop b5. I think maybe she could have tried some waiting move like king h3.
Did you tell me one thing, Prag? To play a move like king f8 because, you know, you make it sound easy. But did you take some time on the board to play king f8 or just naturally you made this move? Because it's a very interesting move.
Because, I mean, I was thinking, I thought there is anything direct because there was nothing. And then I thought, okay, I'll just
improve. And white can't improve their position anyway.
So, like, I was thinking, like, king h3 and now I must go for this fg5 thing somewhere. I wasn't sure to do here or...
Right before the 40th move.
Yeah. So like queen f8 doesn't work, gf6 is there. Maybe I can also do this one and then try to bring the queen. Yeah, it should be somewhere winning for black.
So knight d7 to control the f6 pawn and then free the queen from this.
But there was this bishop b5 thing after knight d7. Is there.
You don't want to trade your bishop for this knight.
So maybe I can try fg5. Fg5 and...
This new variation's
fine. Yeah. Hg5 and then go queen f5. Queen b6 even.
And can they go something like f6 here? You'll just go g6?
Or f6 here, maybe some queen b3 and just exchange.
I'll just trade off, yes.
And then e4 is just fine.
Yeah.
Yeah, something like this should happen. Yeah, but bishop b5 like made things easy actually for me. I just took and played queen a5.
So all endings are going to be winning for black.
I mean, I'm getting tempo with queen a5 actually.
Yeah.
I was thinking should try something like bishop f1.
Were you planning to trade off the queens with queen d2 or what?
Yeah, I could do. I was thinking actually to planning to trade the queens because it's... It's technically winning after queen d2, but now I wasn't sure, like, actually it's not easy to find a move, because, let's say rook d2, then just I mean, bishop g2 should be there.
Bishop g2, do you have rook d3?
And some queen c1 maybe. I mean, if a queen gets in, then it's like...
Yeah, that because your king will suddenly be very weak, no? But probably you can just trade off your queens with queen
d2,
no? Yeah,
that's what I was thinking, like queen d2.
Too many weaknesses in the ending for white.
Rook d2, bishop g2, I think is kind of forced, and rook a2.
Rook a2, yeah.
If rook g3, knight e4.
Right.
So it's winning.
Yeah, this would be...
She tried g6, but it's just winning after h5.
So g6 just was a small trick just to show
that
you can't take because of this, but just simply h5.
Yeah.
Well, now but then she just loses a piece, no?
Yeah, I need to calculate some variation, but it was... Yeah, it's... It's nothing actually. I mean, there was this f6, then I take knight e4, there was this queen h6, but this doesn't work, knight f6.
Oh, this is pretty. Show us why not g8-6.
Yeah, just g7.
Yeah, g7 and then king g8 and f7, yeah?
Yeah, but...
Yeah. But simply you said after queen h6, knight f6 holds it together.
Yeah.
And there's nothing, yeah? Just queen h8, knight g8.
Rook f2, rook f4.
Yes, nice.
So, she went queen g5, knight e4. Here first I was like, just checking this line. It looks just piece up for me, but it's not easy. Because my queen is not doing anything. Should be winning somehow. I was thinking rook d5.
Rook
b2? B2, then rook c5. Yeah, queen
a7. Can you go queen
a7? And then some knight g5, just to defend f7.
And okay, rook b8, rook c8.
Yeah, I'm trying some e4, queen e5 thing.
F6 is not nothing, yeah?
Yeah, rook b7 also e4. Yeah, I saw this, then I thought, okay, I'll just go for it. Queen h5, queen d5, same time, queen g8.
Because after this, you just defend everything.
Yeah, same.
But, you know, it was, it looked like a quite a quiet game in the beginning. But did you always feel like you were the one who was pressing because of your better pieces?
Yeah.
How were you evaluating the position?
Yeah, I mean, I was pressing from, I mean, I think after, like, when I got the AFM knight c5, I was slightly better. I mean, after I got queen f6, queen b6. And, yeah, after that, it was just better.
So around...
Yeah, maybe it should be equal.
Yeah, around this point it was equal, but after knight c5 you got your knight in and queen b6.
Yeah, after queen b6 I think it's already should be. I mean, I have pleasant position already.
And Prag, how are you enjoying Gibraltar so far?
Yeah,
here with your mother?
Yeah, it's good. But I lost the first round, which was bad.
Also with another Indian, with Nandita. Yeah. That was a tough...
Yeah, I played really bad that game.
Yeah.
Yeah, in the middle game I saw a draw, but I just went some crazy things.
You try to overpush on that.
Yeah.
Prag, you're coming from a camp with Vladimir Kramnik. Tell us about that. It's your second camp with him.
Yeah, actually, this time with the Gelfand Sato, and it's very interesting camp. But actually, I could only attend the half camp because I had fever, and I just left the camp. Like I attended the Gelfand camp. Gelfand sir camp, but I couldn't attend Kramnik sir camp. I actually attended in the last 2 days with online, but...
But you had one more before this in...
Yeah, it was in France. And
A group of you went there, 6-7 kids from India. I think it was organized by Chesspace and Microsense.
Yeah, it was very helpful for me.
And I remember the camp even in with the Jakob Agard that we had in Scotland was very helpful because you went and played the next
extra
tournament.
Extra and I won, yeah.
You crushed everyone there.
Yeah, it really helped me a lot.
Okay, great. Well, lots of more games coming up. We look forward to having you with us. Thank you for your time, Prag.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.